Okay, so I'm gonna put my makeup on. First, I'm wearing the Beauty Counter. I guess you're over here. Sorry, Anna's filming this right here, so we're trying to figure out how you can see everything. So I just put a little bit of this on my makeup brush and just brush it in to my face. It's super. I love this foundation. It's healthy, it's clean for your skin, and it does have good coverage. If you're wanting like extremely good coverage, this probably isn't gonna be the best one for you, just because you would have to like layer a few layers, but they are working on some other foundations, so I'll keep you posted as those are coming out. But this is what I wear for like everyday foundation. And then I wear the Armani foundation for like events or if I am gonna be taking a lot of photos, just because of like the way that that formula is a little better for that. So once I get all this blended in, next I add my concealer. So I use the Beauty Counter Touch Up Skin Concealer. It's a clickable pin and it's amazing. I've used like really expensive concealers, drugstore concealers, and this one always seems to be my go-to. And I will wear this with the Armani foundation as well. So you just click a few clicks and put it. I do it under my eyes, and then if I have like any blemishes I'm trying to cover up, I'll just do a few little spots right here. That's pretty much it. I'm gonna take my ring finger and just kind of rub it in. I'm sure I could use like some type of, you know, beauty blender or something like that, but most of the time I'm just going pretty quickly, so this is what works best for me. So just jamming in the background here. I love getting ready with music on. Kind of like pumps me up for the day, you know? Okay, so once you get this rubbed in, forgot to grab a Kleenex. I just kind of wipe it off my hand. I'll wash my hands after I get done with everything. So then next I go with the Beauty Counter Mattifying Powder. So I just put a little bit of this in the top, use my powder brush and kind of just wipe this on my face everywhere. Actually need to order another one of these. This one's kind of light. And then I also, I use the Anastasia palette. And so I use their bronzer, but I use this top one for just like under eye. It kind of like sets my makeup or my concealer. So I usually just like put a little bit of that on there. Then next I do my eyebrows and so with my eyebrows, I fill it in with this Dip Brow from Anastasia, and I just pull like a little bit of it out, put it on my hand like that, and I just kind of dip it in and just come and draw my eyebrows on. I have very thin eyebrows. They're kind of like a light blonde. So I really have to kind of like make some lines with this. Should probably get microblading done, but just haven't done that yet. So my makeup lady at Nordstrom taught me how to do this. And I've been using this stuff for almost a year now. I really like it. And you just kind of like make some lines with it. Could probably come out a little further, but yeah, it's pretty easy. Beauty Counter also has a really good brow pen. I haven't ordered it yet, but I've seen lots of other girls talk about it. So if you're looking for more of a pen and you don't want like this little dip liquidy stuff, that would be a good option to try as well. So that's, so they're not perfect by any means, but you get the picture. So I just wipe that off, wipe this off my hand, and then I move on to eyeshadow. So I have an eyeshadow tutorial on my blog and on my YouTube channel with this exact palette. So I'm not gonna use like all the colors today, but I always use this top one as just a base over my eyes. Super easy. And then I will take another brush and just like do a little bit of the side and just put a little of that right here. Let's see. So once I do that, next I go with this Kat Von D tattoo liner. This is my go-to eyeliner. I've been using this for probably like 5 years now and I love it. So I just draw a little line right here. It took me a long time to get to this point where I don't like have to pull at my eyes. But you could easily just like pull on your eye a little bit and draw the line. And it stays on all throughout the day and it comes off really easily with just like a makeup wipe or like soap at night. So this is like my absolute favorite. Okay, so next I go for some bronzer. Just use this like bottom two kind of mixed together. And then I just kind of spread it right here along the bottom of my cheekbone. A little bit on the top of my nose. And then just like a little under here. And I mean, I could probably be contouring a lot better. I don't really know how, if I'm being honest, but this is just what works for me. And then I get this highlight that's up here at the top and I just kind of like brush that right above that line I just did. That's pretty much it for that. And then last I do blush from Beauty Counter. I absolutely love their blush. This one is the color Flamingo and Apricot. So I just kind of like rub them together and just lightly just like brush it right here on my cheekbones. That is pretty much it. Next I go on to mascara. So I like the Beauty Counter Volumizing Mascara. This is actually a new tube. I just opened it. I do several coats to get it like pretty dramatic. So just add this on. And the best part is that it's got safe ingredients. So having something so close to your eye, it's good to know that like what you're putting on your lashes are actually good for, you know, it's not gonna harm your body. So that is with that. And then I don't know why, and of course I just told you like safe ingredients on the top. I don't know why I don't care about the bottom. But I've always used this Lash Boost Volume 1 on my bottom lashes. It's the only thing that really doesn't ever get a lot of like mascara on the bottom part. you could easily use the same mascara, but I'm just kind of in the habit of using this one though. And that's pretty much it. My lipstick is downstairs, but this is my easy little getting ready makeup.